to work.
I am Lord Otranto of Antiva, rightfully betrothed of Lady Josephine Montillier. Songs of your exploits have spread to my city, Inquisitor. It's humbling to make your acquaintance. It is a pity it will not last longer. Before we duel, I trust you find the weapon to your satisfaction.
Am I not allowed to pick my means of defense?
Ha! Aside from the fact that your mage fire may put me at a disadvantage, I am the wounded party in this duel. Tradition dictates that I select our weapons. There is no shame in a forfeit.
I trust you've made this a fair fight, Lord Otranto.
Upon my honor. Shall we begin? an admirable start, Inquisitor. Perhaps House Trevelyan isn't the obscure backwater I've heard it to be. I'm glad Lady Montilier isn't here, exquisite as I've heard her appearance to be. Cutting you down in front of Josephine would have given a poor first impression of House Otranto to my bride.
Josephine doesn't want this engagement. Call it off.
To what purpose? You can't think I'd...
Stop!
Josephine!
Lady Montilier. What a pleasure to...
What are you doing?
If I duel Otranto to stop your betrothal, any dishonor falls on me, not your family.
I would have found a way around it. The Inquisition needs you. I need you. Yet you threw yourself into danger. Why do this? Why risk everything we've built? Why risk your life?
Because I love you.
You do?
He does?
Yes, Josephine. I love you so much.
I love you too.
Well fought.
Lord Otranto.
I'd assumed your liaison with the Inquisitor was an affair of passion or convenience, Lady Montilier. But I'm not fool enough to stand in the way of true affection. The Otrantos regretfully withdraw the terms of our betrothal.
Thank you.
Do not thank me. I know when I'm outmatched.
I can't imagine a better ending. But wouldn't you be impressed by a dueling scar?
My dearest lord, I love you precisely the way you are. Just do kiss me again.
I can't stop thinking about your duel in Val-Royeaux. Running into the middle of the crowd, the noise, the swords flashing. I was so worried for you, but at the same time, well, it was the most exciting thing I've seen in ages.
I was worried you'd still be angry that I started that duel in the first place.
I was only worried for your safety. Your position allows for so little of it. You know, when I first laid eyes on you back at Haven, I hadn't an inkling we'd become so close.
Something suggested you were special the moment I saw you.
I'm glad it did. These moments seem so dear, especially given your greater calling. Sometimes I must remind myself that I'm required to share you with the rest of the world.
The world may want my time, Josephine, but you have my heart.
Then I count myself happy, beyond compare.
Let's speak later.
Another time. Worship?
What can I get you?
I'll be back later.
I'll be here.
You were there. I have to know what it was like. The colors, the smells, the magic. I'm sorry, it's just so exciting. You went into the Fade. If you have time, Inquisitor, do tell.
You seemed excited that I fell into the Fade as Adamant.
Spring gets me excited. This is a wonder. It's probably hard to relate, but dwarves don't dream. So I can't even guess what it's like. I can't even understand what dreams are. But you were there. And came back. Can I take a sample?
A sample?
Oh, that sounded sinister. I meant, can I cut a little piece off of you and do things to it? That didn't sound better, did it?
You'll have a full report of everything I saw. Will that do?
It's a start. I'm sorry, it's just... This is exciting. It all is. Your piece people cleaned you up after your fall. I wonder if anything is left. So much to think about. Mind your step for things, Inquisitor.
I'll see you later, Dagna.
I can't wait.